So the book of Isaiah is typically divided into three sections. The first is chapter 1 to 39, the second is chapter 40 to 55, and the third section is 56 to 66, the end. And we're about to kind of cross between two sections, what's typically known as first Isaiah, what also becomes, and then the bit that's known as second Isaiah, which is the bit from chapter 40 onwards. And Isaiah as a book spans a whole period of Israel's history, so or Judah's history. So it's before they go into exile, it's while they're in exile in Babylon, and then it's when they come back from exile as well. So the bit that is before they go into exile is the bit that we've been reading so far up until the end of chapter 39. And so right at the end of this bit, you see there's a story of Hezekiah, who again, just to remind us, we read about in 2 Kings chapter 18, 19. And some of this stuff is recorded in that particular bit. So Hezekiah is ill. He turns to the Lord. The Lord heals him through Isaiah and sort of sends this message that there's going to be a healing. And then envoys from Babylon come, and Hezekiah shows them everything, at which point Isaiah gives him a word that eventually everything's going to be carried off into Babylon. Historically, that's what happened. Hezekiah died. There was a couple of other kings. It all went a bit wrong. In the end, Israel got destroyed and Jerusalem was destroyed, and they took the people of Israel from Judah, the land they were living in, off into exile in Babylon. Then they're living in exile, and Isaiah, the prophet, is there. And what he does is he speaks these words of comfort to them. The first 39 chapters of Isaiah, we've probably found a little bit hard going because a lot of it's about judgment. But it gets a little bit more cheerful here. And the opening bit is about how make straight the way for God. The valley's going to be raised up, the mountains are going to be made low. God is on the move and he's going to rescue his people. And I just encourage you, if you have the time, I know it takes a while sometimes to read this stuff, but just to read these words from Second Isaiah again. These are some of the most beautiful passages we're going to read from the whole Old Testament, I think. And what it's really doing here is it's contrasting the power and the majesty and the everlastingness, if that's a word, of God with how puny and tiny we are. And so it talks about how all of the nations, and think about that. That includes, well, for those for the, in our day, if we would say the same thing, it would include America, it would include China, it would include Russia, it would include every nation on the planet, are just like a drop in the bucket for God. It talks about how he sits enthroned, verse 22. He sits enthroned above the circle of the earth, and his people are like grasshoppers. He is just this enormous thing. Who would you compare me to, says God? And he's the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary. His understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary. He increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. If you are tired, if you are weary, if like Hezekiah you are ill and it's hard, hope in the Lord, trust in him, and see whether your strength gets renewed.